I've been young, I've been old, I've been hurt and consoled.
Now, Dawned on Me was a song that when I first heard it, I wondered if it would stay in its essentially acoustic form, like the much maligned collaboration with Feist and You and I, Country Disappeared, or Solitaire from Wilco the Album. Of course, when I first heard it done, it was solo acoustic, so it was kind of hard to judge. But it still made me wonder what sort of headspace they would be in, or they were in, when they finally came down to laying down the track in the studio. This is just me, but on prior efforts and past albums, it seems like a track like this, presented in solo acoustic form or stripped down, it seems like it would have stayed that way, maybe with some slight accoutrement or little addition, but not too much to it. Now, in this case, it was nice to be surprised to see some distortion and edge on a song that lyrically is a little bit on the side of gooey. Though to give it some credit, the chorus parts are infectiously catchy. Plus it has whistling, and if John Lennon has taught us anything about whistling, it's always a good thing. I'm sure that there's more that I could eventually say about Black Moon as I get more and more used to it and listen to it more and more often as time goes on. But for now, it's a very moody, introspective sort of track to me. It reminds me of the deep acoustic tones of Black Eye from the Uncle Tupelo days. The slide, rhythm, and percussion give it this sort of dreamlike quality, much in the way of Sunloathe, but sort of different. The strings also create a very expansive atmosphere that once again sounds like something the Beatles might have done on, like, the White Album, for instance. Something that explores the darkness, searching the deserts and the depths for that elusive black moon hovering overhead.
Never stopped crawling.
Lyrically, it's very elusive in sound, and in a sense, it almost seems like it's lost in a way. Another very pretty track with a lot going on in it and a lot in the background, which is just another bonus to having vinyl. You can pick up on all those great sounds that are going on in there. Born Alone is once again back in something that sounds like it could be almost radio-friendly territory if radio got its head out of its proverbial rear and played good music. However, mostly it's just a fun song with rock overtones that is some of really the best lyricisms and some of my favorites on the record. Much because of what they say or that they have some deeper meaning. It's just that the wordplay is in the style of what made me admire Jeff Tweedy's writing so much to begin with, and really made me want to create in the same sort of way. It's very appealing. The slight vocal layering is also really exceptional here, along with the deeper range Tweedy hits, deeper than really I've heard from him recently, before it crashes into more fine work from Nels Klein and Glenn Cochy as they provide the vital connective tissue that allows this track to really flex its muscle.